Hey guys, welcome to my new series, Smash Movesets, where I make movesets for different characters that I want in Smash. Today is the character I want the most, Steve. So, let's get right into his moveset. So, the first thing I need to mention is, he has a little, like, you know how, like, Cloud has a limit? Steve has, like, a hundo needle, and it goes down as you run and attack. And you would want to keep this at mats with one of the moves. And I'll tell you how you keep that at mats later. He would have two jumps, and he can crouch. His neutral attack, he would be. So for his neutral attack, he would do three punches, and then a block place where the opponent is to do some launch. And all of his tilts will utilize the trident. Side tilt, down tilt, and up tilt. Up tilt would be a throw, but it would definitely not be that high. It would be like maybe as high as his first jump is. Like, and his side tilt would be a quick throw forward, and his down tilt would be just a normal swipe. His neutral special would have him utilize his crafting table. He would use this to upgrade what his side special is, the pickaxe. It would default in battle by wood, and the side special, he would just swing it forward twice. When he used the crafting table, it would upgrade it from wood to stone, but these are only temporary upgrades. And then it would go stone to iron, and then it would be maxed out at diamond. His up B, which is how he recovers, is the only thing similar to moves I've done in the past, but I saw it was too much by Link. So he would place a TNT block right underneath him, and then he would go. He placed a TNT block and then ignite it. And then after about a second, it would explode, launching him upwards. Like, maybe like one block higher than I just got launched in game. His down B is how you keep his hundo needle topped off. Foo. It would go... If you just tap it, you would get a tricky, which only does like half a hundo needle. His next one would have him use a fish, which would heal up about 200 needles. Like, the tricky would do one, this would do 200 needles. Then you have Trick Chicken, which would do 300 needles, and then the final is the Trick Pork Chop, which would do 400 needles. That's all his special attacks. His final smashes. There's three different ones he can do. His first one would have him utilize, it would be the only move where he uses a sword. It would have him use a sharpness 5 diamond sword. It would be kind of similar to Kirby's final smash, where he would do a swipe forward, and if you get caught in it, he would do a quick slash forward, but you would have to be very close to Steve in order for it to work. Like, it can reach, like, maybe, like, if they're, like, the length of the platforms and battlefield away from him. He would swipe, and then whoever got hit by the swipe would be caught in. And then he would do 3 strong hits with the sword, but then his final hit, he would use a debuff stick, but because that doesn't exist in this portion of Minecraft, I'm just gonna enchant it. So it looks like the debuff stick. He would pull out the debuff stick for the final hit of his final smash. Okay, I can't enchant it. Well, he would pull out the debuff stick, and then he would do a final blow. His second final smash, which would be 20% of the time, also the damage would be 75%, 20% of the time would be the nether portal. This would be a cinematic one where it's activated by he quickly builds another portal. and anyone close by would be sucked in to the portal. And then it would show them in the Nether being hit by all the nasty stuff in the Nether. As soon as they just sucked into the portal, a wither skeleton would attack them, and then they would bump into a zombie pigman, which would send an army after them, and then they'd be launched to a lava, above a lava pit, and where a gas would shoot them, and they would launch back out of the portal. And the final one is another cinematic, and it's 1% of the time, where he builds an end portal. He will quickly build this end portal, about a little bit faster than the Nether one was. Like, the Nether would take about 2 seconds to build. This one would take half a second to build. It would show Steve quickly building an end portal, and then anyone nearby would be sucked into the portal. And they would show them in the end on top of one, and they would fall in on one of the towers, and then it would show Steve throw a snowball up, which would explode that end crystal, launching them into the Ender Dragon, who would use his little bowl things he throws at you during the fight to launch them, and then it would show, and then the final shot would show Steve using his diamond sword in his most common final smash to take out the Ender Dragon, sending the foes back into the overworld, to where the battlefield is, and launching them. Okay, now for some level stuff. So it's up taunt. He would eat a gold apple, but this wouldn't affect his hunger beetle. He would just do a trick numb. And it wouldn't affect his hunger beetle or want to do anything. It's just a taunt. The side taunt, he would place a bed, and if certain people are nearby that are like monsters, he wouldn't be able to sleep in it. He would actually sleep in it, not explode like he did here. His down taunt, he would throw up a piece of wood, which would then be placed, and then, he would throw up a piece of wood about here. For his down taunt, he would throw up a piece of wood about to there, then he would throw an ender pearl at it, teleporting him up there, and then he would break the block and grab it as he throws an ender pearl back down to where he would teleport back to where we started the taunt. His costumes, default is obviously Steve, second is Alice, third is Prisoner Steve, fourth is Prisoner Alice, fifth is Mario, sixth is Link, seventh is Banjo, and eighth is Herobrine. His grab, he would use a fishing rod, and his pummel, he would stab them with a stone shovel. And all of his throws, he would use a piston. His first victory, he would mine up a diamond. His second victory, he would have another one enchanted sword and use it to tail off the wither, then look at the camera and do a little crouch dance. And then his third, it would show him crafting a tate, and then he would place the tate on that crafting table, and then he would quickly build a little stand, and a random foe that he defeated would come up and buy the tate with whatever they can use. Like, if it was Link, it would be a rupee. If it was Mario, it would be a coin. If they don't have coins in their game, then they would just give him an emerald. And then Steve would look at the camera, and hold up his coins that he just got. And that's all that I made for Steve. I think the Hundle Meadle is an all. I think I'm the first one to actually use a Hundle Meadle. So I hope you enjoyed this moveset. Bye!